Creating Dynamic Histograms in Excel. Hi, I'm Dr. Nick from Creative Maths and Statistics Learning Center, and in this video I'm going to show you how to make dynamic histograms in Excel. To start with, I'll show you a completed histogram so that you can see where we're headed, and this is the data we're going to be using, which is taken from the game show Deal or No Deal. And you can see that this is a histogram of the winnings from lots of different people. Now down the left hand end, you can see I've got a figure here less than or equal to $5,000. So you can see that 57 people won less than or equal to $5,000. And then up here we've got greater than 70,000 and one person won more than $70,000. And in between you have the different amounts. You can see this terminology here. You've got a parenthesis on the left hand side and a square bracket on the right hand side. The way this terminology works is that the left hand bracket is a less than amount and the right hand bracket is a less than or equal to amount. So you can see that this term here, 5,000, 10,000, means that the amount is between $5,000 and $10,000, and it includes scores of 10,000, but it does not include scores of 5,000. If you're going to print this out to use in a report, you might need to reformat what's happening down below here, but as a mathematically correct way of doing it, this is great. Now that you've seen where we're going to, we'll have a look. I'll show you how to make this. So here we have the data on its own. We highlight the column with the data in, we go insert, and we go to charts. In this case, it has recommended the histogram we want, but if it doesn't, you go to all charts and choose histogram, and you choose the one without the line on it. So here we have a rough idea of what the histogram is going to look like, but you can see there are some strange things happening down here. That is because Excel has arbitrarily chosen the bin sizes. The bin size is the width of the interval. You can see that this column contains all of the values between $9,400.50 and $18,800.50, which are sort of odd numbers or weird numbers. So we want to fix this, and we do that by right clicking and selecting Format Axis. I will move the dialog box over here so that we can fit more on the screen or make the screen bigger. Now you can see at the moment it's got automatic, and we don't want it automatic. We can say what we want the bin width to be, and it chose a bin width of 9,400. So we could try 10,000. And you can see that as soon as that's entered, it changes the width of the bins so that they're including a wider range of values. You can also see we've got this problem with the 50 cents down there, and it's a bit annoying. So what we can do about that is put an underflow bin and make it go from, or we say anything under 10,000. So that nicely changes that to less than or equal to 10,000, and now we've got much more rounded or sensible looking values along here. Now I don't think that this is really telling us as much as we might want, so I'm going to change my bin width to $3,000. But when I do that, we get this strange crenellated effect. So you've got these high values and low values. And that is because this interval here, 13,000 to 16,000, includes 15,000, which is a value that is more likely to be given out as a prize. We can actually see this is quite interesting. If we want to make it 1,000, you've got lots and lots of little numbers, little bars down here. So you can see it's not evenly spread over the thousands. And when you have something like a $3,000 bin width, you get strange effects. So we're going to go for 5,000. And make sure that our underflow bin fits with the 5,000 as well. And now we've got even bins of 5,000. So we do have this strange one out to the right. So what we'll do is we'll make an overflow bin. So I will change the overflow bin to $70,000. And so now you can see you've got one over here with greater than $70,000, and all of the others are just equally spaced $5,000 intervals. We can look back at the spreadsheet we're trying to get to, and you can see I've got a heading, deal or no deal winnings. I've got an x-axis label of amount won, a y-axis label of amount number winning this amount. These are all done by clicking on the graph, going to design, and going to add chart element, and adding primary horizontal axis, primary vertical axis, or adding chart title. Now the thing about a histogram being dynamic is that we can change some values and the histogram itself will change. So say all of these values suddenly became 20,000. You can see that this bin here has grown a lot and this one's gone down because this reflects the data. So I'll just take it back again and you can see that. So when we change the data, the graph changed. When we change the data back, the graph changed back. And that's the beauty of this. The old kind of histogram that you used to make in Excel was not dynamic. So each time the data changed, you would have to change the histogram itself. So that's about it for now. You might want to know some more. And if you do, put a question in the comments below and I'll make a video to explain anything that wasn't clear here. So remember to click on the like, subscribe to this channel, and click on the bell to be notified of any new videos that will help you with your statistics. So happy times with Excel and statistics.